What is up, everyone? Welcome back to another Star Wars Galaxy of Heroes mod guide. Today we're hopping into the Phoenix Squadron, one of the best early starting teams in the game. Going to go through all the characters for that to help you guys get the most out of that team. A big shout out to Sir Hayes, one of my subscribers, for suggesting this video. So we will get started. But first, if this is your first time to the channel, please consider hitting that subscribe button for some more Star Wars Galaxy of Heroes content in the future. All right, let's hop over and we'll just kind of go through these characters like we always do. All right, first one, this is probably the most important character within the Phoenix Squadron. One, he's going to be putting out the most damage, but then also he is useful in other teams later down the line. So he is a good investment as far as gearing him up and then also for putting solid mods in him. Now, across the board from everything that I looked on, this seems to be the setup that you want to go with. You want to have a crit chance and crit damage set for him. And a lot of these characters just in general play around what their unique bonuses are when they're put underneath the Hera lead as a complete team. So this is going to be your main damage dealer. You're going to want to get high crit damage with this character. So the main focus for him, just like a bazillion other characters, is speed. Now, this team in general, it's going to be one of those do as I recommend, not necessarily as I do. I've kind of been past this team for a little bit now, more into the mid-game teams. Going back and remodding this team has not been a huge priority for me, but I do still use Ezra. So speed, offense, obviously is the only thing that you can use for your primary on a transmitter. So you're going to want secondary speed, crit chance. Offense is also good for him as well. For the receiver, speed is going to be your main focus here. Definitely, like I said, offense percentage is going to be good for him. Crit chance is also going to be helpful since you're going to be wanting those big crits with this character. All right, for primary stats on your processor is going to be defense. It's the only thing that you can use. Same thing with secondary stats that you're looking for. And then holo arrays for him, you're going to want a crit damage holo array. That's going to be a main focus because you're going to want those big hits because he does crit quite often. He has the double hit on his basic. So, a lot of times you can put out solid damage with him and you're going to want those crits. All right, for the data bus, most recommend protection here. I put this on there because it was a high speed mod and I didn't have another place to put it, so it's a health mod. I don't think you can really necessarily go wrong with health or protection on this team for the most part, because there is, in Zeb's kit, you are putting protection out to the entire team underneath the Hera lead, and that is going to be based off the max health of your character. So that's going to be helpful to get your protection up based on that move as well. So health's not bad, but protection is good as well. And then for his multiplexer, I put in protection with speed, just to kind of make him a little bit more survivable. One thing about this team in general, it out survives a lot of teams. So if you make them a little more tanky, a lot of times you can get through some more difficult teams just by out surviving them and working one character down at a time. All right, so next character we are going to look at is Chopper. Now, for him, I've seen several different variations, and for mine, I just went for survivability across the board because he doesn't do a lot of damage, but he can soak up some hits, dodge some hits, and then remove some taunts as well, and then spread some buffs out to your team on his basic. So I made him more survivable, went with a health and defense set. A lot of this is because these are some leftover mods that I just had and filled in just to make the character better. But for him, mostly defensive thought when I went going through here. I did do speed on the receiver to make him quite a bit faster. It's got good protection on it as well. For this one, potency is not very good for Chopper at all. But I think the only thing that you would use that for is like stunning droids with one of his moves that potency would be good for. Went protection for all of these, for the data bus, for the holo array, and for the multiplexer, just to make him more survivable. Now, hopping over quickly to Crouching Rancor, they recommend a speed and health set on him, a lot of protection for the triangle, circle, cross. For the arrow, you could give speed or protection. So a lot of based around him is maybe speed and, as far as survivability is concerned. But I went with this health and defense just because I wanted him to survive longer in the battles. And it kind of helps that team as a whole when he is able to soak up some hits. Now, for Hera, you're going to want speed and health mods. For her, my mods are not that great on her. I've got just kind of some secondary stuff on here. For the receiver, you're going to want to have a speed arrow there. If you are using this team quite often, it's going to be better to have her faster. I had protection available, and didn't have another speed arrow of, to put on her at the time. So this was more of a, thought of keeping her more in that survivability mode. Like I said, this team can just outlive other teams, especially in early game. They're hard to get through, and you can just outsurvive them. All right, so for her, for the holo arrays, for the data buses, and for the multiplexer, I went protection for all of those. I think that that's kind of been the recommendation on a lot of the stuff that I was looking at for her as well. So you're looking at protection, 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 yeah, across the board for what Crouching Rancor is recommending with her. Now, the next character that we're going to look at, I definitely disagree with some of the stuff that I saw in Crouching Rancor for him. I went survivability with this character, and I really like what, see, they're recommending him have speed with a crit chance set, which doesn't really make a ton of sense for his kit to me. So I really like what they're recommending over here on gamingfans.com though. For him, they said the main focus, the key is for Kanan is survivability, specifically health for this Jedi tank unit until Mods 2.0 was released. The focus on health is because the unique abilities of Phoenix Tunes, which are shared under Hera's lead, Zeb's unique, along with Kanan's special total defense, especially deals with protection up. But since max health determines protection up, it will benefit more for having high health on this character. So that's kind of what I recommend for him as well. Going high health mods, defense mods are going to be some good ones as well to kind of help make him a little tankier, because he really is there mainly as a support tank role. He can take some debuffs off characters, but you're going to want him soaking up the hits for the team, and making him survivable is kind of where it's at. I don't really see the speed or crit chance going well with him. So you see, I did a lot of defense mods, protection mods on this character. Some of this is because they were leftover mods. I did crit avoidance on arrow. That's kind of what I had available. Probably speed or a protection mod there would be better for him. But make this character survivable. He's definitely not a damage dealer whatsoever, so you're going to want him soaking up hits for this team. Now, Zeb, this is one that you want speed and potency on. Zeb's main focus on this team, one is his shrug off ability that's going to be going out to your whole team, is giving your team protection up. So that's very, very helpful. But you're going to want him getting those dazes out, those staggers out, those stuns on characters. So it really can kind of mess up the team. So I went with a potency speed set on him, mainly focusing on potency. I want those dazes to hit. Dazes are extremely important in this game. And then this character stuns, he throws out stagger. It's really, really important to be able to hit those. So I went mainly potency where I could go potency with this character, and a little bit of survivability going on as well. And then, so this arrow I would like to replace. It doesn't really have a whole lot of stuff that I want, but he is one of those characters that you can get a little bit of offense out on this team as well. So it doesn't hurt to have some offensive base mods on this character as well, because you're really, if you go for the main lineup for Phoenix Squadron, a lot of people don't farm Sabine since she's a hard node farm. You're not going to have two damage dealers in this team. You're going to have a lot of tanks and supports going along with Ezra, really the only one that's putting out damage. So this one, Zeb, like I said, more of a control character. You're gonna want for those dazes and stuns going out on the enemy squadron. All right, for Sabine, the last one that we are gonna look at. For her, I definitely don't have her modded correctly at all, so we're not necessarily going to look at my mods. I do think potency is good for her because of her demolish ability. That puts out a lot of buffs on the board, so it exposes and staggers the target enemy for 2 turns. So this is going to be, another one that you're going to want good potency for to get those debuffs out. For this one, I believe is unavoidable for the armor shred, so you don't necessarily need potency for that one. And then for her, just based off her kit in general, will give you a good idea of what you should be going for with her. So she gives out critical chance and critical damage to the team. So what you're going to want for her is to have a critical damage and a critical chance set for her. You're going to want a speed arrow, crit damage triangle. She's modded very similar to the same way that you would want to mod your Ezra. So if you do farm her up and make her a part of the team, just farm her the same way that your Ezra is going. You're going to want good damage out of that character. But that is it, guys. I hope this was helpful for you to give you an idea of where to go with this team. I will leave some links down below to Crouching Rancor so you can check out and just have that guide available for you. And then also to the Kanan section on the gamingfans.com, I think is the best way to go after Kanan. I definitely don't really understand the advice from Crouching Rancor on the way to mod Kanan. So I definitely recommend going to gamingfans.com for that one. But hopefully this was helpful for you. And if you've got some more teams that you want me to cover, characters that you want me to cover for mods, let me know down below in the comment section, and I will see you guys in the next video.